Talk about some of the other agile companies that you've experienced and worked with.
So we try to use a variety of historical and business case studies. The invasion of Normandy to us was an ultimate example of agility, both strategic and tactical. Everybody focuses on the actual D-Day invasion and the heroism and amazing perseverance and improvisation of the American soldiers. We just celebrated 75th anniversary of that. And all of that is absolutely true, and we highlight it in great detail in the realm of tactical agility, because they've encountered so many surprises and so many obstacles and setbacks, and yet they were unified around their mission. They were empowered, they were trusting their colleagues and their leaders, and they persevered, and that changed the course of history. But that preceded by many years of strategic agility, where American leaders essentially determined that they could not coexist with Nazi Germany, unlike the leaders of the Soviet Union. They transformed the entire US economy into the arsenal of democracy. They created enormous amount of innovation, and then they prepared for D-Day. So again, top-down vision, planning, really concerted effort that only senior leaders can do, then transitioned into amazing tactical agility. So the two work together. We present a number of other business studies. We show how movie company IMAX dramatically transformed itself and essentially overcame what many consider to be an existential threat in the digital world to a company whose projectors were the size of a fridge. We also talk about Western Union, which has been in existence for 150 years and has gone through, you know, telegraph and then telephone and the internet and now the digital age, and how that company transformed itself to really become a player in this new world when everybody was doubting that the company would even survive. So, but again, every time we use these examples, we return back to the question. These are the steps. These companies detected change, they assessed it, they shaped the response, they executed. Are they prepared to do it again? Have they embedded all of these steps and all of these qualities in their leaders, in their culture, in their processes, in their knowledge, so they can do it again and again and again? Because one of the major requirements for agility is to be able to repeat this process as the next disruption occurs, as the next change occurs, as the CEO leaves, as the culture changes.